Hello, my dear students. Welcome to the e-class started by St. Joseph Academy, Mariam Nagar, Ghaziabad. This video is for class 3rd, subject Social Studies, chapter 6, and the topic of the chapter is calendar. This video is prepared by Renu Martin. Students, in this chapter, we will learn how the calendars were made and what is the significance of calendar. We will also learn how to personalize our own calendar. So, first of all, we will start reading the chapter. A calendar is a chart or series of pages showing the days, weeks, and months of a particular year. Students, I think all of you have seen calendar at your home. So, a calendar is a chart which is having all the days, weeks, and months of a particular year. It also gives seasonal information. In the beginning, calendars were developed to track the different seasons and farming timing. It means in the beginning, the calendars were developed mostly to track the different seasons, means winter season, summer season, autumn season, and the other seasons, and to know what type of farming is good for that season. Though there are many types of calendars, yet the Gregorian calendar is used all over the world. So we are also using the Gregorian calendar. This calendar was introduced in 1582 by Pope Gregory XIII. We find a calendar in every house. Calendars keep us updated and informed. Some people hang the calendars on the walls. Calendars are also made to lay flat on a table. Nowadays, digital calendars are becoming very popular. So, students, I think all of you are having calendars on wall in your houses, and some also having calendars which are flat that you can keep on a table. And now, as you can see in your parents' mobile phone, they all are having digital calendars. Calendar structure. Now we will learn the structure of our calendar. Following are the months of the Gregorian calendar. A year is divided into 12 months. January, the length in days are 31. It means in the month of the January there are 31 days. February, 28 days. And in leap years, February is having 29 days. March, 31 days. April, 30 days. May, 31 days. June, 30 days. July, 31 days. August, 31 days. September, 30 days. October, 31 days. November, 30 days. December, 31 days. There are 7 days in a week. A week has 168 hours. Let us calculate it. 24 hours are equal to 1 day. 1 week equal to 7 days. And 1 week equal to 24 into 7 is equal to 168 hours. It means in 1 week there are 168 hours and there are total 7 days in a week. Students, all of you know the days of the week, but let us revise once more. That are Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. There are 4 or 5 weeks in a month. 12 months make a year. A year has 365 days. It means in the whole year, there are total 365 days. While a leap year has 366 days. As we also read that in February, in leap year, there are 29 days. So, in leap year, there are total 366 days. That is why this year is called leap year. A leap year comes after every 4 years. 7 months have 31 days each and 4 months have 30 days each. It should be noticed that February has 28 days, but in the leap year it has 29 days. The 29th day of February is known as the leap day and the month is termed as the leap month. Significance of calendars. Students, now we will learn why calendar is more important for us. A calendar is more than just dates. It tells us about different events and stories about our communities. There are number of reasons why we need calendars. Let's read them below. So students, now we will read why calendar is very important for us. The first point is, planning the daily activities becomes much easier with a calendar. Second, to keep a track of events. Third, staying organized and enhancing productivity. Fourth point, remembering birthdays and other important events and dates. Fifth point, knowing the important festival dates. Sixth point, keeping a track of school events, national events and family events. So students, as we read, you can understand why calendars are very important for us. We can plan our daily activities in a very easy way with the help of calendar. We can also keep the track of school events, national events and family events. And it will be also very easy to remember birthdays of our dear ones, identifying and marking important events. Now we will learn how we can identify or mark the important events in our calendar. A list of events such as birthdays of family members, family events, national festivals, and school events can be marked on the calendar. Let's see how can this be done. India has 3 national festivals. These are Independence Day, Republic Day, and Gandhi Jayanti. Independence Day occurs on 15th August every year. So, we will mark the 15th day of the month August. Students, as you can see in this picture, it is the picture of the month August 2017, and we have marked here 15th August. The 15th day is marked with a different color and a note is given mentioning the occasion. Similarly, we can also identify different festivals. You can see down the picture, there is also a note that why we have marked the 15th August, because it is a Independence Day. So we can also mark other festivals in the same way. Students, look at the calendar of October 2017 on your screen. Looking at the calendar, we can say that Gandhi Jayanti falls on 2nd October on Monday. Diwali falls on 19th October on Thursday. And Bhai Dooj falls on 21st October on Saturday. Personalizing your own calendar. Now we will learn how we can personalize our own calendar. As a calendar is necessary to keep a track of the events in your daily life, you can personalize it in your own way. Let's learn how. You can mark important events at school and home in the following way. Mark the important dates by circling the numbers and make a note of the event at the bottom. This would help you to remember the events and manage your schedule properly. Students, as you can see on the screen, there is a calendar of November and we have marked few dates in this calendar. And below the calendar, you can see why these dates are marked. So, in the same way, you can also personalize your own calendar and can mark your important dates and events. Now we will revise the important points that we have read in our chapter. A calendar is a chart of pages showing the days, weeks, and months of a particular year. The Gregorian calendar is used all over the world. The Gregorian calendar was introduced by Pope Gregory 13th. 12 months make a year. There are 4 or 5 weeks in a month. A year has 365 days. A leap year has 366 days. A leap year comes after every 4 years. In the leap year, February has 29 days and the 29th day is known as the leap day. Planning daily activities becomes much easier with a calendar. Now, after reading the chapter, we will start our exercises. Choose the correct option to answer the following questions correctly. First, a calendar shows the options are days, weeks and months, both A and B. And the correct answer is both A and B. It means a calendar shows the days and weeks and months. Number two, which calendar is used all over the world? The options are the Gregorian calendar, the Julian calendar, none of these. And the correct answer is the Gregorian calendar. Third, the Gregorian calendar was introduced in 1550, 1582, 1682. And the correct answer is 1582. The fourth one is, a year with 366 days is known as a, the options are leap year, spring year, common year. And the correct answer is leap year. Our next exercise is answer the following questions. Our first question is, explain the term calendar. And the answer is, a calendar is a chart of pages showing the days, weeks, and months of a particular year. The next question is, write in brief about leap year. And the answer is, a leap year has 366 days. It comes after every 4 years. In the leap year, February has 29 days. A question number 3 is, name the days in a week. When will the next leap year come? And the answer is, the days in a week are Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. The next leap year will come by 2024. Question number 4 is, why are calendars so important for us? And the answer is, calendars are so important for us because, first point, for planning the daily activities, second point, for remembering birthdays, third point, for knowing the important festivals dates. The next exercise is mark right on the true and wrong on the false one. The first is, a calendar is a chart showing the days, weeks, and months. It is true. Second, you cannot personalize your own calendar. It is false. Third, nowadays digital calendars are becoming very popular. It is true. Fourth, a leap year has 364 days. It is false. Fill in the blanks. First, a calendar also gives dash information, and the answer is seasonal. Second, Pope Gregory introduced the Gregorian calendar. Third, February has dash days in a leap year, and the answer is 29. Fourth, Tuesday comes after dash and the answer is Monday. Our next exercise is match column A with column B. The first point is Gandhi Jayanti falls on and the answer is 2nd October every year. And the second point is calendar keep us and the answer is updated and informed. Third point, the leap year is divisible by and the answer is number 4. Fourth point, September has and the answer is 30 days. After the exercises, now students, I am giving you a small home assignment. Make a calendar of any one month showing the prominent national and school events. Students, as we have read the chapter and I hope that you also understood it. I am requesting you to watch this video again and read the chapter carefully. Thank you.